Good afternoon, Joe for Jaspy's Hobbyland here. We are doing 2016 Panini Contenders Football. It's a 12 box full case random division break. This is random division break number 3 from JaspysHobbyland.com. We are giving away one Super Bowl square. That'll be at the very end of this video. Big thank you to these folks for getting into the action. Really appreciate it. And there are the divisions right there. We're going to randomize both of those lists 8 times. 4 and a 4. 8 the hard way for 8 people and 8 divisions. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Derek Watley in the pole position and Kale in the number 8 spot. Nice. And we've got 8 times for the 8 divisions. Good luck, divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. NFC North on the top, AFC East on the bottom. All right, here's how it all shakes out, folks. 60 to 72 autographs coming your way. Derek, NFC North. Rick T, NFC East. Look at that. Jeremy Merle, AFC South. Mike Coster, NFC West. John, you've got the NFC South. Mark with the AFC West. Mike Coots, AFC North. Kale, AFC East. So we're going to pause the video, see if there's any trades when we come back, and then we'll have the break. So stick around. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back, everybody. There were no trades, so that list right there, alphabetized by your first names now, remain the same. Full caser, so settle in. Get an adult beverage if you are of age, or get a glass of milk or a juice box if you're not of age. Relax, settle in. This is going to take a minute or two. After every box, I will be recapping all of the autos. So if you are rewatching on YouTube because you missed the break, remember you can just kind of you can press the letter L, I think, on your keyboard to fast forward every like 10 seconds or so, and you should be able to see me doing an auto recap at the end of every box. So I'll be either sleeving them up or showing them again or something like that. And I'll leave the autos out on the table too, so we can kind of keep track of how many autos have popped out of there, et cetera, et cetera. All right, so thank you very much, everybody. All right, so without further ado, thanks for your patience. And here we go, folks. Good luck. Good luck to Kale, Derek, Jeremy, John, Mark, Mike, two Mikes, Mike Koontz and Mike Coster, and Rick T. We'll open up all the packs first. And here we go. A lot of great stuff in Contenders. Obviously, you see a lot of the Contenders cards end up in buyback products, graded and in buyback products like Leaf, TriStar, Super Break, and all that stuff. So that's why the set is really has been popular over the years. Rookie heavy. So you're going to see a lot of these, you know, for every, there'll be some rookies where you're like, who? And then they'll be like, oh, dang, that's a really great card. The cracked ice has been traditionally pretty popular over the years, seeing all the cracked ice cards. So any pretty well-known rookie with a cracked ice autograph, always strong. So it should be pretty fun. There you go. Chase is saying he pulled a Carson Wentz cracked ice out of one of these boxes, and it goes for about $750. So there you go. So you can always see the value for that. And it's worth, like, cards like that are worth keeping as well. It's because you can always hold on to something like that, get it graded, and then if Carson Wentz turns out to be, you know, MVP or a Super Bowl winner or something like that, you know, that the value of that card will certainly go up, because this is like, you know, for like rookies, this is like the rookie card you kind of want to have. This always holds its retains its value a lot better than a lot of other football cards over the years. So there's a lot of great value in Contenders. It's a long break for sure, but it's worth it. We've done a number of pick your team cases, and we've done a number of this is our third divisional case. So you can see that it's pretty popular. All right, box number 1. Good luck, everybody. Contenders. Get ready, folks. Here we go. Box number one. Okay, I'm going to start off with these guys here. So, vet base doesn't ship. Pretty much all the base cards are veterans right here. So, all this vet base is not going to ship. These kid reporters, we're not going to ship those to you either. This Jordan Howard autograph, however, we will ship. NFC North, that's a nice start. That goes out to Derek Watley. Nice. Jordan Howard, because of some injuries, was lucky enough to get some playing time, and he made the most of it. Nice one, Derek. Sean says he just got a contender PYT 5 stuff today. Excellent. Good. We'll randomize these off left and right as well. Inserts like this will ship. We'll even send stuff like this too. I know some people think that there's a little value in here on those gold ink autographs, so we'll still ship those out as well. I know some people wanted those. Obviously, we're not pricing our cases or anything like that dependent on those gold ink autograph values or whatever value they may or may not have, but we'll still ship them anyway. There's Jeff Driscoll in his 49ers gear, but properly on his Bengals now. AFC North, that'll go to Mike Koontz. There's my boy Derek Carr. Going to need him back next year.
You guys don't want to work on that right now. You guys just want to break something.
We've got Justin Simmons for the AFC West. Broncos guy. That goes out to Mark.
Like I said, browse around the website right here. Let me see those orders come in, guys. We're down to 8 left in Black Diamond.
And another Bronco. Andy Yanovich. Another one for Mark in the AFC West. More round numbers cards that we will actually set aside. MVP contenders. And oh, this will ship. Look at this. Jameis Winston. 85 out of 99 championship ticket. Nice. That'll go to the NFC South. John Parker with that one. We should have a couple more. Yeah, Keanu Neal. Nice Keanu Neal for the NFC South. He's been playing pretty well for the Falcons, I believe, along with, his safety, right? I believe he's been playing pretty well. Along with Vic Beasley Jr. on the Falcons. That's going to be a great game this weekend. Separating out some of those cards. I'll do that later. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just 5 in this one. Bears, Bengals, Broncos, and Falcons in this one. All right. Next box. Nice. Apparently, Dak and Zeke are on the cover of Beckett magazine for January. Nice. Chase said he got a backwards Zeke card, but it was just a base when he flipped it around. He was mad. I know that happened to me too. There's been times where I've been trolled by Panini a number of times. Where I think, oh, this is going to be an autograph. Nope, not an autograph. You think they intentionally do it? Maybe. Yeah, there have definitely been times. Oh, he's boy is saying February, he means. Dak Prescott and Zeke on February. Julio Jones is on January. That AFC and NFC conference championships are going to be really two really exciting matchups, I think. Andrew says, you bought 20 packs of contenders and got nothing. Where'd you buy them?
How many packs are in the box?
Well, I'm thinking if you bought blaster boxes, you can't really expect too much out of those. But if you buy like actual boxes, you know, then you get 5 autographs per box, so. Andy Yanovich. Looks like Mark is starting his Andy Yanovich PC. He has the AFC West as his second in 2 boxes. Well, did you buy an actual box, Andrew, or were you just buying packs out of a box? Jordan Reed, NFC East. Out of 249. That goes to the Redskins of the NFC East. Rick T with that one. We got Cody Core. Autograph. Nice. Rookie roundup auto for the AFC North. Nice one for the Bengals and the AFC North. That'll go out to Mike Kuntz. Nice. You should have just bought the box, Andrew. That's what I always suggest. Legendary contenders, Ravens, AFC North. That's 85 out of 199. That's Ed Reed. Nice. Cody Kessler. Nice. Rookie of the year contenders. 20 out of 25. That is nice. AFC North. Right on the card as well. That is very cool. 20 out of 25. AFC North. That's for Mike Kuntz. There's Nelson Spruce, NFC West. Rams. That will go out to Mike Coster. A couple different mics in this break. And what else do we have here? Emmanuel Ogba, another one for the AFC North. AFC North doing well. It's not bad. Save those round numbers cards. Save the Kenyon Drake. And that's Peyton Barber for the Buccaneers. That'll go to the NFC South. Now, before I go through this, let me... to go through that other stack of the other box I just did. I need to pull out the all of the non-vet based, because we ship all the inserts. This just helps the shipping team get it to you guys faster. William is here. What did you miss? Everything. You should have been here since the start. Missed everything. Let me just sort out this box right here, because we got to pull out all the... I should have done this from the beginning. This is going to ruin my break time. This is not going to be a record-breaking time, that's for sure. All right, so all that stuff is shipping. This just helps, get this to you guys a little bit faster. So, yeah, that ProSize will ship. So most of it is vet-based, so you're not going to get most of these cards. All right, that's it. All right, thanks everybody. So box 2, this is what box 2 had. We got Emmanuel Ogba, Rams. We got that nice Cody Kessler, a couple more Browns, and another Bronco. All right, and a couple of these nice inserts here as well. Next box. All right. Thomas. Let's see. You got four spots yesterday, but you only had two in the giveaway? Oh, well, I probably messed up, Thomas. I apologize about that. Send me an email about that at jaspyshobbyland@gmail.com, and let me confirm that for you. Let me just double check your orders and confirm that. Once I confirm that, you're probably right. I probably messed up. I will just add two spots for you in the next All Spots Sold promo that we have. I think that's the easiest way to do it. Sorry about that. And Daniel Erickson, if you're looking to do any selling or whatever, please do that in our Facebook group. Oh, is the audio behind? Let me pause the video. All right, welcome back, folks. We were just adjusting some of the settings right here. Well, I can't open a pack while I'm recording right now, but here we go. Okay, yeah, I'm recording right now. Welcome back, folks. I pause the video for just a second. We want to adjust some of the settings right here, but we should be a little bit better on the syncing of the audio and the video. We'll keep playing with those settings. It is way better? Okay, awesome. So, good. We already had Noir Soccer, and then we already sold it. All right. Next box, there's Terrell Pryor. Remember, Vet Base is not ship. And if you're like, oh, this seems like a long break, it is a long break, but it's a good break. There's DeMarco Murray, 94/99. If you want to break something else, you can always go to the Hockey Channel and check out Jason Jaspy. He's in the other studio over there breaking some hockey. That's something you can do with him. There's Roger Lewis, NFC East, New York Football Giants. All right, still need a handful of autos from this box. Let's see what we got. Dak Prescott? Is that a troll or is that an auto? It's an auto. Rookie of the Year autograph, Dak Prescott. Nice. NFC East, Rick T with that one. Goes along nicely with your impeccable Ezekiel Elliott. Right, Rick? Nice. Congrats, man. That makes it worth it. There you go. Nice Dak. Dak attack. Cody Kaur again for the AFC North. That's out of 25. 14/25 Bengals. Mike Kuntz with that one. Save those round numbers. Save that Derrick Henry. This Cody Kessler will go to the Browns. We got legendary Ray Lewis, number 52, obviously. Cody Kessler, what time is it? Game time. Brandon Williams, Cardinals for the NFC West, going out to Mike Koster. We got for my Raiders, nice playoff ticket autograph right on the card out of 199, DeAndre Washington. AFC West Mark with that one, which was DeAndre Washington was definitely a revelation for my Raiders this season, along with Jalen Richard. Very nice hit. Save those inserts will ship, and obviously this will be randomized separately because it's numbered 25/199. All right, so there's DeMarco Murray and a number of autographs right here. Including that Dak Prescott. Very nice. Yes, Ron, just autos in this product. No relics. Autos and numbered parallels. Oh, there's Game Time 1, 2, 3. There's Ray Lewis right now in the Breakers.tv stream. What time is it? Game time. What time is it? Game time. Any breakers in the house? Woo, 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 woo. That pumps me up. I wish there was a... I've said this before, folks. I'll say it again. I want to patent this idea. I want to talk to Ray Lewis about this idea. Ray Lewis needs an alarm clock. Right? Imagine Ray Lewis waking you up every morning for work. How pumped would you be for the workday? Got a crappy job? No worries. Ray Lewis is there to pump you up. You know, have a long day of meetings? Don't worry. Ray Lewis is there to pump you up. A Ray Lewis alarm clock. Every morning, Ray Lewis wakes you up. What time is it? Wake up time. Right? What time is it? Coffee time. Right? Ray Lewis just, woo, pumping you up like that. Oh, man. I would buy like 3 of those. Ray Lewis, if you're listening, stop doing motivational speaking. We don't need that. Stop doing motivational speaking. You know, get going on that alarm clock. Pump me up every day. You know? That's what I want. That's what I want. The Rock has one like that? Yeah, I mean, I don't know if The Rock pumps me up as much as Ray Lewis, though. That's the thing. That Ray Lewis pregame stuff always pumps me up. That's what I like about Ray Lewis. So Ray Lewis, if you're listening, I've got a business idea for you. They'll be hilarious. Trust me. It'll be good. It'll be great. It's a free app? The Rock one? Well, see, I want to make money off of it. All right, next one, folks. Here, actually, that'll go to the Texans. Will Fuller. Speaking of the Texans, nice on-card auto, AFC South, Jeremy Merle with that one. Josh Doxson, Rookie of the Year contender. Just download the sound to your phone and somehow... I hate ads. Nothing worse than a free app with a bunch of ads. I'd rather pay the dollar or two. Rookie ticket, auto, Kavari Russell, Bengals, AFC North, Mike Kuntz. Ron says, just download the sound to the phone, somehow attach the alarm clock. That sounds like too much work. If I'm going to put in that much work, Ron, I'll put it towards an app, sell it with Ray Lewis as my buddy, and then my friend Ray Lewis, Joe and Ray, hanging out together. There's Nick Vinette, Seahawks, autograph for the NFC West, and Mike Koster. Yeah, I want to make money with Ray Lewis. That's the whole point. James Davidson, what's going on? Sean Peak is your 11 out of 24 cracked ice autograph for the New York Jets. Kale with the AFC East. Nice. Eli Apple of my eye is another autograph of the NFC East in Rick Thomas. First rounder. And another Jet. And that would be Robbie Anderson for the Jets. AFC East, another one for Kale. And we've got... a numbered card right here, 42 out of 99, touchdown tandem. That's pretty cool. DeMarco Murray, Derrick Henry. Both for the Titans, both for the AFC South, and Jeremy Merle. And that's it for that box, folks. Moving on to the next. All right, so there's that Titans card, and here were your autos. Jets, Giants, and then Jets again with that cracked ice. Seahawks, Bengals, and Texans. Nice. Next box. Good luck, everybody. This is a full case divisional. Number 3 is what we're working on right now. In the meantime, if you want to break something else, we still have a ways to go here. So if you want to break something else, you can go to jaspyshobbyland.com and get a head start on another break, or visit our hockey channel. So if you just search Jaspy's Hockey Land on YouTube, you'll be able to find the live stream of our hockey channel, or on breakers.tv/Jaspy's Hockey Land. And check out our hockey products right there. Jason Jaspy is in the other studio right now here at the store. And he's talking hockey, busting open some hockey. Some pretty fun and affordable breaks on the website too. So if you want to check that out, go for it. A lot of value in hockey as well. That's exactly how I want it, Benny. That's exactly how I want it. He's like, Joe, your hair's a little wild in the back. Just looking out for you. I know. That's exactly how I want it. I looked at it and I said, I guess that's how it's going to be today. I don't worry about my hair that much. I'm not a teenage girl. Hey, if the hair is wild, it's wild. Sometimes it's tame. Sometimes it's wild. Sometimes it's a hat. Every day, something new. Every day, something new. I like it wild. What if I intentionally did that, Benny? I like it wild in the back. Oh, you found some sound for me? See, I don't need sound though, William. I need Ray Lewis. I can find sound anywhere. I don't need that. I can just pull audio, make an Apple audio. No, I want to talk to Ray Lewis. I want to sit down with him, have a business meeting with Ray Lewis. Talk to him about this alarm clock idea. Actually make alarm clocks with his mug on there. You know, that's what I want to do. All right. First one, Von Bell is your first autograph. NFC South. That will head out to John Parker in the NFC South. I will, Benny. That's what I've been doing. I think it works. Nate Sudfeld is your other autograph. Redskins with that one. NFC East, Rick T. And Redemption coming up right there. See that? We'll send that Wendell Smallwood to the Eagles. And that Redemption, let's see what it's going to be. Redemption is Hunter Henry. Nice. Rookie ticket RPS Hunter Henry. AFC West. Going out to Mark. Now 021 with that one. Nice Chargers right here. Hunter Henry, the future Antonio Gates, right? Supposedly. Although Antonio Gates is still intending to play, I think. Good for him. I'd play as long as possible, too. We got a bird right here for the NFC South Panthers. That'll go out to John Parker. You like our Instagram, Tyler? Thank you. We do too. Got legendary contenders, Eddie George. Nice. That is out of, can't see the number there, 72 out of 99 on that one, Titans. AFC South, Jeremy Merle. He's pretty legendary, isn't he? And I think we need like one more autograph out of here. There it is. Leonte Carew. On card autograph and sepia. 166 out of 199. AFC East and the Dolphins. Kale with that one. Nice. And there's Derrick Henry again. Be cool to get his autograph. Derrick Henry has one of the nicer autos in the hobby. All right, end of box recap. We've got AFC East, NFC South, AFC West, NFC East, and NFC South. There you go. And here's the additional parallel right there. That's number. That's Eddie George. And the next box, actually, we'll do this one over here. Good luck, everyone. Thanks again for joining this divisional. At the end of this break, I'll be randomizing a Super Bowl square. If you're wondering what a Super Bowl square is, we have the details on JaspysHobbyland.com. Check it out. Be there or be square. Don't be square. All right, folks, let's talk about it. AFC Championship, who do you have? NFC Championship, who do you have? People are, I saw earlier in the chat, people are saying what? That the Patriots are, it's foregone conclusion? Patriots are automatically in the Super Bowl? Automatically going to win? I don't know. Patriots are a very good team, but they haven't faced a big offense like Big Ben. Antonio Brown, Le'Veon Bell. They also have whether they meet the Packers or the Falcons, they haven't met a high-powered offense like the Packers, a quarterback like Aaron Rodgers. They haven't faced that all season. They haven't faced a Matt Ryan, Julio Jones combination that shred defenses left and right. So I think it's not going to be as easy as Patriots fans think it might be. There, James Davidson saying, Steelers and Falcons in the Super Bowl. That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, I don't think it's a foregone conclusion that the Steelers are just gonna roll over against. Now it is in Foxborough. It's gonna be difficult. I'm not saying it's gonna be easy, but don't just assume that the Patriots are gonna win this one. If now Big Ben does struggle on the road, but if he decides that this is the one time he's gonna do well on the road. You know, and Le'Veon Bell goes off, you know, and, you know, Antonio Brown goes off. You have a game now, folks. It'll be exciting. But either way, I feel like any combination of any teams in the Super Bowl should be pretty exciting. I mean, I'd watch any combination of any AFC team and any NFC team in the Super Bowl. William saying New England versus Green Bay. There's Mike Thomas in Los Angeles. Cracked Ice, 20 out of 24. Rookie ticket auto going out to Mike Koster and the NFC East, or NFC West, that is. Dano says he hates all four teams. He hopes they all lose. Dano's a Seahawks guy. Speaking of the Steelers, there's Javon Hargrave. Steelers with that young defense, but strong defense. AFC North, Mike Kuntz with that one. Not steel curtain strong, but they've got some young players out there fly around the field. Scooby Wright, the third for the Cleveland Browns. AFC North, Mike Kuntz with that one. Save that one. That ships. All this vet base does not ship. All this vet base does not ship. But this one right here does ship. And that is... Nice, Rookie of the Year contender, Laquon Treadwell. That's a 5 out of 5. I think that's our first train whistle in this set. At least my first train whistle in this set. 5 out of 5, Laquon Treadwell. Nice. There you go, NFC North. Derek Watley, all aboard the Big Hit Express. Woo-woo! You got the first train, or my first train whistle out of this contender set. Nice. And that goes to the Jaguars. There you go. Nice hit indeed. AFC North, Bronson Cafusi going out to, that heads out to Mike Kuntz. Redemption coming up. Any guesses on that redemption? Oh, that ships. It's going to be another Hunter Henry. AFC West, another one for now 021, who is now starting his Hunter Henry PC. Dano says Team Tebow. If Tebow popped out of here, I'd be like, did I open up the wrong case? We got playoff ticket, Matt Forte, 69 out of 249 for the AFC East and Kale. Let's see what else we have here. I think that might be it. And that's it, folks. All right, you got Ravens. You got that nice Vikings 5 out of 5. Browns, Steelers, and cracked ice Rams in there. So that was a pretty fine box, including this playoff ticket card of Matt Forte. Who do I want in the Super Bowl? What would be my preference? Troy's like Christian Ponder came out of here. I would also look at this case and be like, did I pull open the wrong case? I'd like to see Green Bay and the Patriots. I think that would be the sexiest matchup there. You know, I would think you want to see two quarterbacks like Aaron Rodgers, like Tom Brady, squaring off against each other. You could probably get a high scoring game out of there too. Oh, hey, John, you got the NFC South. I don't think there's been anything significant for you at this point. Does anybody remember if there are any NFC South autographs for John Parker? I feel like I did call out his name for something. Maybe a Buccaneers player or something like that. No, there was like a Panthers autograph. I think there was a Panthers autograph somewhere there. But you have the NFC South. But still a lot of boxes to go, John and everybody else. A lot more autographs to go. Oh, yeah. There was a Falcons. There you go. Yeah, Keanu Neal. That was a good one, John. Yeah, thanks, Mike. There you go. All right, a few more packs to go, and we'll see what's in this box. Another 5 to 6 autographs to go. Plenty of boxes to go. So do not despair yet if you have not gotten a big hit. Thus far, still plenty of time for big hits. All right, good luck, everybody. Next box. And our first autograph is Jonathan Bullard, Bears, 11 out of 99, NFC North. Another one for Derek. There you go, Derek. Next one is Jeremy Cash for the Panthers. That's for John Parker in the NFC South. All Another NFC South. James Bradberry for the Panthers. Look, John shows up and only a couple NFC South players popping out of there. Legendary contenders. And a Paxton Lynch autograph. Nice. 46 out of 49. Paxton Lynch auto. Right on the card going out to the AFC West and now 0-21. Nice Paxton Lynch. We might see him this week as a part of the NFLPA Collegiate Bowl festivities. We'll be doing some breaking with Panini on Thursday and Friday. This Thursday and Friday, so be sure to watch our live stream. We'll be broadcasting earlier, so you'll have to keep an eye out. So make sure you subscribe to our channels so you know exactly when we're on. It's Connor Cook. That'll go out to the AFC West. Sean Sanity, what is a Raz, he's asking. Can someone explain to him what a Raz is? It's not something we don't do here. Not exactly super legal. Raffles. Titans, that goes to the AFC South. Jeremy Merle with the Kevin Dodd. Mike Coster's a Packers fan. He definitely wants him to go, obviously. It'd be great to see. I mean, it's a good storyline. I mean, Tom Brady looking for his fifth. Nice D-Rob. 175 out of 199, right on the card as well. Chiefs, AFC West going to Mark. Tom Brady's going for his fifth Super Bowl. And Aaron Rodgers looking for his second after 6 years. You know, a lot of people thought, is Aaron Rodgers really the guy to do that again? You know? Well, now he can put to bed those storylines. 13 out of 99. This will actually be randomized separately. Yeah, that NFC Championship game will be a shootout. Hopefully, Jordy Nelson will be healthy for that game because then you can really see two great offenses on display. And that'll be a very exciting game. And then we'll see which defense steps it up. What's up, Max? All right, so we got that D-Rob for the Chiefs, Kevin Dodd, nice Paxton Lynch, a couple Panthers, and a Bear. All right, next box. Almost there, folks. Getting there. I think the AFC conference game should be pretty good too. I think Pittsburgh generally struggles in New England over the years. I think they certainly want to get that monkey off their back, you know? So that's been weighing on their shoulders for a long time. There's no love lost between those two teams, so you know that the Steelers definitely want to do really well. And so I think that game, lot for the Steelers to prove, so we'll see how they do. Yeah, I did see replays of that, Dan. That missed tackle from Clay Matthews. Ezekiel Elliott just kind of steps and then spins around. I'm not going to recap the hits for all the people that missed them. Negative. At the end of, we will upload this video as soon as the break is over. And at the end of every box, I recap the autos from every box. So people will just be able to fast forward and see. Yeah, Mike Coster saying Steelers blitz a lot. And the Houston Patriots game showed that Brady doesn't handle that kind of pressure very well. That is true. I think, you know, I think the Texans really kind of showed a good defensive model on how to, you know, how to battle Tom Brady. All you got to do is put a little pressure on him. It's hard to do. It's not easy. And he's still a great quarterback. He handles the pressure pretty well. But that's, you know, that's one way you kind of try to limit Tom Brady's quarterback play. All right, next box. Start off with Joe Flacco. 49 out of 249 for the Ravens. AFC North. That'll go to Mike Kuntz. And NFC North, Rookie of the Year contender, Mackenzie Alexander, Derek Watley with that one. Well, easy on the language there, boy. It's a family show, but he's saying that Brady is a B word. I don't know if he is he? I mean, yeah, you can't call a five-time Super or four-time Super Bowl winner a baby, you know? Kind of hard to say. There's Peyton Barber autograph, NFC South. That'll go to John Parker. I mean, I don't think he complains any more than any other NFL player. Right? I mean, to be honest here, every quarterback's a crybaby. Every quarterback complains, oh, he hit me too low, hit me too high. Wah, wah, wah. They're all crybabies as far as I'm concerned. There's Von Bell, NFC South. I believe that's a second one for John Parker in the NFC South. Well, yeah, that's the difference with Cam, is that he doesn't get calls. Like, look at the stats, and you'll see that he actually has a little bit of a right to complain. There's Bart Starr, Packers legend, 75 out of 99, championship ticket going to the NFC North, and Derek Watley. Right, but as far as I'm concerned, everybody complains. Nice, 10 out of 25. On card auto, Paul Perkins. Going out to the NFC East and Rick T. It's another nice box there. Jalen Mills. Nice autograph. Philadelphia Eagles, another one for the NFC East. Wow, looks like the break spot sold out in the Hockey Channel. Nice, all breaks are now unlocked in the Hockey Channel. Go, go, go. What's up, Frank? What's going on? Pulled a Dak Prescott. That guy's okay. Yeah, we still have a ways to go before we finish with this break, folks. So if you want to join a break with Jason Jaspy really quick, he's got a lot of nice, fun, and affordable breaks on the Hockey Channel and on the Hockey website. So we got Eagles, Giants, Saints, Buccaneers, and Vikings. A couple nice numbered cards here, too. All right. I know, that dude's trash, right? Come on, Joe. Weak. Dak Prescott autograph, weak. Yeah, he's no good. They're not even in the playoffs anymore, Frank. That auto's worth $0 now. It's all right, man. Sometimes the bad language spills out, but we try to keep it a family show. I keep all of my cursing off air. Ooh, someone offered you $1,000 for that Willie McCovey sketch card from Transcendent. You can't pull the trigger though? That's a good deal. I think that's pretty good. I mean, like I said in the Facebook group, Frank, like most of those one-of-one sketch cards were going anywhere from, you know, high 700s to maybe $2,000 around there. I think that's a pretty good price for Willie McCovey. But yeah, it is a cool card. It's hard to really – that's why I wouldn't get into like Transcendent Baseball breaks. I would be too afraid to get like a really monster hit and then be unable to sell it. You know what I mean? I'll be like, I should sell it, but, you know, like, but you can't. Like, how are you gonna sell something like that? You know? Like, you're not gonna, right, exactly. Frank's like, I'm probably not gonna get another one most likely. Yeah, what are you gonna do? Like, you're not gonna buy another one back for $1,000, right? Like, it's tough. It's tough. Now, if it was Willie, you know, me being a Dodgers fan, I'd be like, you know, forget Willie McCovey. I'll be happy to sell that. You know what I mean? But if I got pulled like a Sandy Koufax or something like that, holy crap, like what am I gonna do with that? Like, I guess I'd have to keep it, right? All right, next one is Andy Yanovich. Another one for now 021, who's building his Andy Yanovich PC. There you go, Mark. Make sure I'm not mixing up these cards. Okay. All right. Mike Koster saying, I've been still been on and off the fence to sell the Aaron Rodgers printing plate auto. See, it's tough. And see, you're a Packers fan. That's got to be tough. Playoff ticket, he's in. Antonio Brown out of 249. Antonio Brown likes live streams. He should come and visit us. Live stream with us. It's okay here, Antonio Brown. It's okay here. Kenyon Drake out of 199. On card auto going to Kale in the AFC East. And you saw that Daniel Braverman right there. NFC North for Derek out of 199. Da Bears. Frank saying the guy trying to purchase that sketch card says he had 28 of the other sketches. Wow, so he's trying to build that set. Sounds like he's trying to build a set, right, Frank? I would just wait until yours is like the 65th sketch that he needs. Legendary contenders. That oh, would that be nice? No, probably not. Another Daniel Braverman autograph, not numbered. Derek, starting your Daniel Braverman PC. Points, boo. Always a couple points in there. Reward store is solid though. The Hackenberg and Malcolm Mitchell for the Patriots. And we've got another Keanu Neal. Nice. This time it's 15 out of 99. Nice one for John Parker and the Dirty Birds, the NFC South. Kessler, Rookie of the Year contender. Got a couple Panthers right there. Weird season for the Panthers. I feel like they'll bounce back this upcoming season, though. I don't see why not. It's not like those players suddenly suck now. All right. Oh, Rick T wants me to take another trip to Dallas. I see. He's got the NFC East in this one. Falcons, Bears. Dolphins and Broncos. So Rick T suggesting, why not go back to Texas? Why not go back to Dallas? Go back to the Dallas-Fort Worth area. All right, we'll see. Hey, still 5, 10, 15, at least 15 autographs to go. Everyone still has a chance for some big stuff here. No. No one's gonna subscribe to you, man. You're done. Banned. No self-promotion here at Jaspy's Hobbyland, folks. If you're listening and you're thinking, oh, maybe I should get all these people to subscribe to my BS channel, don't do that. No one wants to subscribe to your channel. We want them subscribed to my channel, Jaspy's. But this is not a community message board where you can just advertise your own stuff, you know? Don't post your lost dog stuff here. You know, don't post subscribe to my like prank channel. No one cares about that. No one cares that you're opening up a box of 2013 Topps Chrome football. You know, and your haphazard production quality. Nobody wants that. Nobody wants that. Banhammer. That's what happened, folks. Watch out. Could happen at any time. Could be you. All right. Well, almost done with this one, folks. The Hockey Channel is still filling up some breaks, so check that out, JaspysHockeyland.com. And we're also doing I don't know what we're going to do after this, but go to JaspysHobbyland.com, the main channel website, and let's see what we can break after this one, folks. Oh, although Dano is selling cookies. He's self-promoting cookies. PM me for details. I do like cookies, though. See, but here's the thing, Dan. You're actually pitching like something, like cookies, right? That kid right there, all he did was drop in a link and was just like, just subscribe to my channel. Okay, why? What's on that channel? No one cares about that. Subscribe arbitrarily? No, you got to pitch me on that. Now, Dano pitched me on cookies, you know? Like, that's a good pitch. I like cookies. I can deal with cookies. Can't just be arbitrarily be like, subscribe to some random channel just because you wrote that in the chat. It's like, why? Why should I subscribe to your channel? Kids need to do better marketing. James Bradbury, Panthers, NFC North. You gotta brand yourselves better, kids. You can't just be like, hey, subscribe to me. Why? Why should we subscribe to you? Say, hey, I've got a channel that does this. You know, you might be interested based on your related interests. Brandon Cooks had a 249 playoff ticket. But, and, you know, and then you pitch that to have people subscribe to your channel. And then I'll ban you after that too. But still, I'll respect you for it. Because that was a better pitch. Jonathan Williams for the Bills. On-card auto AFC East for Kale. Oh, yeah. Dan got himself a case of Contenders. And he busted open half of it. And Fast Frank was like, yo, are you going to open up the next half of it? And he's like, Dan's like, I will later. I don't know how Joe does it. My thumb is sore. Because I'm a pro, Dan. 45 out of 49 championship ticket autograph. NFC South, John Parker with that one. Nice, Vernon Hargreaves. Jeremy Cash. I feel like that's another Jeremy Cash. Hello, I'm Jeremy Cash. Going out to the NFC South, John Parker with that one. Brung, 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 brung. Points. That'll be randomized to one person in the break. I hear the train a-coming. Trevor Davis. I go to the Packers. It's coming around the bend. Jacoby Brissett. Nice autograph. Rookie ticket auto going out to the AFC East and Kale. Nice. Legendary Contenders. And we've got Miles Jack here at the end. 67 out of 99.
Hey, Ben. What's an apology?
Why?
Because you abandoned his little brother.
Why should I apologize to him for him spamming my chat? That guy called and said I banned his little brother and wants an apology from me. Why should I apologize? Your little brother is the one spamming my room. No. No ban. No apology. Sorry. It's ridiculous. Can you believe that? The gall. Little brother was misbehaving. I should apologize for banning him. That doesn't make any sense to me at all, ladies and gentlemen. Doesn't make any sense to me at all. Does that make sense to you guys? I don't know. I don't think it does. Well, Dan's like, wow, that's funny, right? He actually called on the phone. Yelled at Axel. Poor Axel had nothing to do with it. Did he actually yell at you? I don't get the logic there. Spam my room. Got banned. I should apologize. Does not make sense at all. There's no logic there. People should just know better not to spam other people's. I don't go into a Starbucks and say, hey, I don't go to Starbucks and say, hey, go to Coffee Bean. Hey, go to the other coffee place down the street. You get kicked out of that Starbucks too. I don't go to McDonald's and I don't go to Walmart and be like, hey, go to Target. Better stuff on sale there. Thank you, Fallen Prime. I am correct. Thank you. You know? I don't go to McDonald's and be like, hey, go to Burger King. Check out, hey, sign up for go to Burger King. Sign up for the deals on Burger King. No, any business would kick you. This is a place of business, folks. Any person would do it. Oh, is that person calling again? Unbelievable. All right, second to last box, folks. I'm not sure yet, Fallen Prime. We're going to have to check JaspysHobbyland.com once I'm done with this break, and we'll see what happens. We've got Jordan Payton Browns, AFC North. That goes to Mike Koontz. Yeah, he said, subscribe to my channel. I need X amount of subs, blah, blah, blah. And he wants me to apologize. No, for banning him? No, I don't need to talk to that person. 145 out of 199, Rookie of the Year contenders. Will Fuller. DeAndre Washington. On card auto, rookie ticket auto, AFC West. That'll go out to Mark.
Yeah, like I said, I don't know what's going on. I'm in the other studio. But if people drop in links.
Cracked Ice Kenny Clark.
We just consider that scamming.
10 out of 24, Cracked Ice NFC North. Nice, Derek Watley. There you go. Yeah, he was spamming the chat. He got banned. Done. We're not. I'm not apologizing for that.
Yeah, but I'm sorry.
So that's what happened. Darian Thomas, Giants, NFC East. Rick T.
Okay.
Thanks, James Davidson.
All right.
I don't need to call him back. The person doesn't. There's no explanation that.
He said you lost a customer. I'm like, oh, okay.
Okay. Well, sorry. That customer obviously hasn't been shopping for very long because you haven't been watching. You would have known the rules.
That's not on their website that you can't drop in YouTube links.
Well, the person clearly hasn't spent more than like 2 minutes on the site, so.
All right, whatever. I just answered it because it's not 6 o'clock. It's not closed yet. After 6 o'clock.
Tyreek Hill, nice. AFC West, now 021. Listen, if you have an issue with that, you know, if you've been here for longer than a day, the person says you've lost a customer, but if you were really a customer and you spent any kind of time here at Jaspy's Hobbyland in this stream, you would know that that kind of thing is not polite and inappropriate. So, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say to that. So, don't lie to me. You know, obviously that person's username was new and not a regular here. And if it was a sibling of someone regular, I banned your sibling, not you. Chiefs, Giants, Packers, Raiders, and Browns. See, things go off the rails during a contenders break. Jackson asking what happened? Well, someone just randomly dropped in, someone whose username I've never seen before in the YouTube stream, drops in a link. You know, yeah, just tuned in, says Rory. No, it's not a big deal. It's just some kid just dropped a a link into the or a text into the chat saying, hey, subscribe to my channel. I was like, no. And it's a username I've never seen before. You know, so it's not like if some kid who was chatting for a while and then dropped this link, then I'd be like, come on, you don't do that. I would have been a lot more considerate about that. But someone I've never seen before drops a spam, subscribe to my channel, please, all caps or whatever. I banned the person, and then the person's like older brother or something like that calls the store and goes, hey, you should apologize for banning my brother or something like that. And I was like, what? I'm apologizing because your brother spammed my chat. And I was like, no, I'm not going to do that. Then he called again a second time and then said, oh, you know, like you've lost a customer. And I was like, that person really wasn't a customer, because if it was, then, you know, you would have known the rules. And this is not the dude I timed out earlier. No, completely different. Like I said, I know I've seen Tyler in the room many a times, just chatting, you know, and contributing to the conversation plenty of times. No, this is someone I've never seen before, Rory. Someone whose username I've never seen before. I don't know. I mean, hey, if you're still listening, you want to state your case or need a better explanation, you can email us at jaspyshobbyline@gmail.com. I'll be happy to discuss this further with you. You know? Oh, Rick T saying, whoever has the Browns, check the Jordan Payton auto, because some of them have Paul Perkins' auto on them. Oh, is that what you were talking about earlier, Rick? I kind of half saw that in the chat. And Rick was like, hey, was that the error card? Hold on, give me a second here. I'm already not going to miss... I'm already not going to make my best time for this, so we can. That looks like Jordan Payton, doesn't it? Did we pull a Paul Perkins auto earlier? No, I don't think we did, right? Oh, we did. So Rick T saying that the misstickered ones actually sell pretty high, the error. But it looks like there's Jordan Payton, there's Paul Perkins' autograph. It's pretty clear that we got the regular one. We got the correct one. Oh, the horizontal ones maybe have been screwed up. Did we get I don't think we got a horizontal Jordan Payton, did we? I don't know. I'll look through those. That'd be interesting. All right, last box, folks. Good luck. And a couple randomizers. We got Justin Simmons. Another one for the AFC West, and now 021. We've got MVP contenders, J.J. Watt, 56 out of 99. It's my boy Derek Carr. Can't wait till he's back and healthy. Oh, there's Farrell Cooper. We were just talking about him, Mike Coster. There he is. Rookie roundup autograph, Farrell Cooper, NFC West. Going out to Mike. And a redemption coming up. There's Mike Zimmer, coach. Mike Zimmer. There he is. Coach's ticket, NFC North. Don't see a lot of those coach autos. Going out to Derek Watley. Derrick Henry, and we've got Brandon Doty for the AFC East going out to Kale. And the redemption is, wow, Sterling Shepard, Tyler Boyd, dual autograph. Well, that'll be a randomizer too. So a lot of randomizers to do here at the end, folks. So it's going to look like this. It's round numbers. But I guess it'll have their autographs on it, obviously. That's a cool one. It's Carson Wentz. There's Derrick Henry. And there's Robert Kelly, rookie roundup. Nice. He helped some fantasy teams towards the end of the season. NFC East, Rick T. Got a Dak out of here, Rory. That was the big one. A lot of other solid autographs. A couple cracked ices and whatnot. A couple Hunter Henrys. But obviously the Dak Prescott was the big one. And that's it, folks. And of course, that dual auto right there is pretty nice, too. All right, Redskins, Dolphins, Vikings, Rams, and Broncos. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video really quick. I'm going to set up these all these randomizers, and then when we come back, we'll do the randomizers, and then we'll do another randomizer for the Super Bowl square. We're going to do all that at once. Actually, this is a numbered card, 37 out of 199 touchdown tandems. Sleeve that up, too, for the AFC North. The AFC South gets the J.J. Watt, of course. All right, so we will be, let me set up the randomizers. We'll be right back. Stick around. All right, welcome back, folks. We got the randomizers all set up for these cards right here. So we'll just do left, right on these cards. Then we'll randomize these cards individually just because they were numbered. Then obviously the dual autograph. Then we'll see who gets points and the Super Bowl square. The points in the Super Bowl square randomizer will do all in one list. So the top person will get the Super Bowl square. Next person gets 250. Next person gets 250. Next person gets 150. It's just kind of easier to do it that way. Let's go and randomize all of those lists 8 times. 6 and a 2. The left and right first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8th and final time. Right side with that one. So on all of these round number cards, it'll be the right side that'll get those cards. All right. Now the round numbers card, 25 out of 199 right there. That's actually what the dual auto is too. So the out of 99, Giants and Bengals 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4, 5, 6. 7 and 8th and final time goes to the Bengals out of 199. That will go to the AFC North, and that is going to Mike Kuntz. So there you go, Mike. You'll get that round numbers card right there. Another round numbers card, Ashawn Robinson, Lions, Jerron Reed, Seahawks. That's 13 out of 99. Randomizing that one 8 times. Up, Flamin, what's going on? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Seahawks out of 99. We'll get that round numbers out of 99. NFC West, Mike Coster with that one. So there you go, Mike. You'll get that one right there. Rory says the autos are horizontal. So this Tyler Boyd, Sterling Shepard, dual round numbers, dual auto. It'll kind of look like that, except this way. It's pretty cool. So you get a visual example of what that looks like. All right. So Sterling Shepard or Tyler Boyd, one of those folks will get the dual auto. Good luck. 8 times once again, right? 6 and a 2. 8 times. So there's 1. There's 2 times. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8th and final time goes to... stays with Tyler Boyd on top. AFC North, Mike Kuntz with the Bengals and the AFC North. Nice. All right, so there it is. Tyler Boyd wins that randomizer. Bengals and the AFC North with that dual autograph. Very nice. And then Super Bowl squares and the points. So let's go back to our other screen. Let's get everybody's names here from Kale down to Rick. So the person on top will get the Super Bowl square. The second person will get 250 points. Third person, 250 points. Fourth person, 150. So half the crew will get something. Once again, 6 and a 2, 8 times. Good luck, everybody. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8th and final time. Name on top, Derek Watley with a Super Bowl square. Nice. Mike Koster, you get 250 points. John with 250 points. And Rick T with 150 points. There you go, folks. That was Random Division Break number 3, a full case break of 2016 Panini Contenders Football. We've got plenty of football on the website, ladies and gentlemen. So let's do it. Thank you very much. This is Joe for JaspysHobbyLand.com. We'll see you next time. Bye.